I've never dreamed I would one day step into parliament, but being home for 7 years, doing projects as a layman and as a public servant for the people of Wabag, I've seen the need to actually go on our bigger stage and deliver. So that was the factor, the motivating factor behind my decision to actually contest the election. So, well, the first session in parliament was good. I was so proud to be among the group that I was. You could see people who've actually made it through life, very credible people, people with integrity, leaders of this country, and I was so proud to be among them in the opposition, representing our people. So the first day was quite good, to be honest with. I wasn't nervous because I was in good company. The experienced politicians actually gave us a rundown of what to expect in parliament. They were there, they supported us. So it was all good, the experience was quite good. My decision to enter politics was basically, was a difficult one because I'm coming from a profession that I was in, medical profession. The profession is quite demanding, but it's a very good profession because you get a lot of good feedback from the public. When you see people getting better, when they leave hospital, you get a lot of satisfaction out of the job that you do. So leaving the hardest decision I made was actually leaving that career behind, a career that I loved so much. It was a difficult decision, but I had to make that decision taking into account the difference I hope to make in the society. I actually graduated, did my master's in surgery in 2009, and being a surgeon, it's quite a demanding job. You don't spend a lot of time with your family. You tend to spend a lot of time in the hospital looking after people, and being the provincial surgeon for 7 years, that job was quite a demanding one. But while doing that job, I actually helped out in, you know, establishing some projects back home. And while doing those things, I realized that, you know, if I could go on a bigger stage, I would do more to help my people. At the end of the day, being a medical doctor, we're helping people, but on a smaller scale. But if I had to enter politics, I thought would, you know, I would help people on a bigger stage. So that was the decision I made. I'm happy I made the decision. Now that I'm in opposition, I'm happy that I'm in an opposition that is vibrant, full of people with a lot of experience. And for a very long time, we haven't seen a good opposition as what we've actually seen today. We have an opposition that's made up of people, very credible people, people with a lot of experiences. And I'm pretty sure we're a credible alternate government that is in waiting. And hopefully, when we do get the chance, I believe we'll make a lot of difference in society. Our country, being an educated person, you know, the social indicators, the economic indicators are not really good. We're actually on a decline. And unless there's a drastic change in the direction that we are taking, I think we're on the, you know, verge of submersion. Our country, we are losing our country to foreign interest. So that was basically my reason for joining the opposition. I actually want to see a change in direction. I want to see credible people take the helm and lead our country in a better direction, because the decisions we make now, it's for our future and for our children's future. We are building a future for our children, and unless we do it properly, we are actually selling our future to foreign interests. So that's basically my decision. I'm actually in the opposition. I'm happy. I'm happy to contribute in whatever way I can. Coming from a medical, you know, fraternity, I'm happy to, you know, offer my advice and things concerning medical, you know, health and stuff like that in this country. I'm pretty sure if given the opportunity, if this opposition is given the opportunity to lead the country, I think we will see a lot of good changes coming up, because there's a lot of credible people on our side. I feel more like a thorn among roses, being my other MPs on the government side. Now that, you know, a lot of people are happy I made the decision. You know, Wabag people are really happy they I made the decision, but still there are some people who are not happy, thinking you have to be in government to deliver. But I don't think that's a correct concept. It's a concept that's actually developed by our current regime, you know. We're trying to suffocate people in the opposition so we can move them across to the government side, but it's not a good concept. I think development funds should be given to all MPs regardless of their alliance. And I'm pretty sure with the people I have around, I can deliver to the people of Wabag. So, you know, I believe in myself and I believe in the people around me, and I believe I can do a better job in Wabag. And hopefully in the years to come, we can make Wabag a model district for the country. Thank you. Now, line lo place. Me talk thank you long online where voting may come inside. Auka basilam nyam nam nam voting nyam 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 auka pandak silam. Kare yang opposition ini karo nabing gipsa ke jimino. Eba bindu nam karo nyam ngeba ipilip nyam nyam kanjepal. Thank you le. Ola bawe.